Ladies and gentlemen, putting an Apple CarPlay in Mason's car, but as you guys can see, he does not have the OEM iDrive screen or whatever it's called. I offer on my website this kit that comes for E92 and E90s. Even if you don't have the iDrive screen, we offer this for sale. You gotta cut a hole in your dash, which is Mason's favorite part of this whole thing.
Not my favorite.
Yeah, it is. So the actual first step is to lay the sticker template over top of this. It comes with a couple harnesses here, a bracket, and then it comes with a little center console control thingy that replaces that thing. We got the backup camera with it, so we're also gonna be wiring that up. Not too bad. It's the same exact one as on mine with the iDrive screen. This is all backup camera shit, and this is all screen shit, and that's all shit. All right, so the first thing we're gonna do is just rip the bottom part of the template off, and you just kind of want to line up where you want it.
Where do you think it should go?
I think right there is money. Look, so you could be laying back like this, right? You could be watching a little hubby and go.
No, I'd rather the passenger seat.
You want the screen over there?
That'd be tough, Luke.
No, it would not.
Oh, don't say that.
Dude, that looks like shit.
Appreciate it.
All right, so what we gotta do is with the bottom sticker, you want to put the top sticker over top of it so that way the red lines match up and along with the green line, so it'll just make like a plus type thing. And it is gonna have a little bit of trouble sticking to the dash. But after a whole roll of scotch tape, we got the thing to stick down.
Somewhat.
It actually comes from factory like that. I can't see that. I'm telling this.
Yeah, we fucked.
I accidentally ripped that right there, but it's all good. So now I'm just gonna use a little Dremel cutting wheel to cut off the red line. Turn the video off, they were watching. We know how to do this. So to get the leather off the dash, what we're gonna do is just use an X-Acto to cut at the red line. And then once we get the leather off, we're gonna use a Dremel with a cut wheel to get the plastic part of it off. Mason just went ahead and cut out the top layer. So it looks like there's probably leather and then foam and then plastic underneath. That was probably the most nerve-wracking part that you gotta do. And then from there on out, it's probably pretty easy. You have a little bit of play if you mess up a little bit because the actual screen itself has a little bit of a lip on the end of it right there. So it'll cover up most of the lines. From here on out, you really just wanna get foam out the way now, just follow the same lines, and then the plastic with a Dremel tool. She's wondering what clothes. Alright, so Mason actually just left because he has to go to the DMV and do some stuff real quick. It's absolutely pouring outside. I plan on going all the way to Delaware later, probably in this video. Big raining. Now, I did get the entire thing cut out. There's a bunch of plastic pieces all over the place. As you can see, we got the general cut out right there. So I'm going to go ahead and try to fit in the screen now because we do have the hole cut. But I'm assuming I'm going to have to cut back a little more stuff because I cut a little less than needed to. So that way it's perfect. So I'm going to take the screen out so I can just have the little plastic piece. I'm going to start from putting the back because it's got these metal prongs. The back in first. There's going to be a little foam padding thing. I don't really know what this is called underneath of it. So you do want to go ahead and remove that so you can route the wires through everything. So I'm just going to pull this out. And that's just trash. So don't even worry about that. I'm gonna try to get this plastic frame fitted up on there and slowly grind down the sides until I can get it to fit in there nicely. So I got the hole up here cut, and I've been slowly cutting a little bit more and more so I can get this to fit in there. So the right side is fitting up pretty nicely just where we want it, but the left side is giving me a little bit of a hard time. So I think I'm actually gonna go ahead and pop this trim piece out just so I can get a hand underneath. All right, so now I can get my hand under here and try to get this thing fitted in there nicely. I got this piece where I kind of want it. There is going to be a hold that holds it down a little bit, so I'm not really too worried about it coming up a little bit because it's just going to hold it right back down. I'm going to go ahead and pop this radio out, take a flathead, and then pry the little tabs off the side. So I got this out the way. So I'm going to pop these connectors off like that and set that aside. In order to get the radio out, there's two Phillips heads on each side. You just got to pull out, and then the whole thing comes out. Now we got the radio out here. And then next, you just want to go ahead and remove all the little connections back here. We got this completely out now. Now, if you see this piece right here with the green and black wire on it, that is actually the audio cables. If you are having audio troubles while doing this, double check those. Make sure that you swap those over to the new little harness that comes with the kit. So this is what we're gonna be using right here. Pop out these green and black cables right here. So just like that, we got the black and green cable. And then that's where you want to take your new harness right here, the one with the yellow, white, and orange wires all over it. Take the black and green wire and stick it on the outside. There's two slots here, and you want to make sure that you put it on the outside slot. As far as orientation, you want the green wire on the outside and the black wire on the inside, if that makes sense. And then the other end of the harness, this is on the kit. It has the female side. You just want to plug the female side into the OEM connector right here that we just pulled the green and black wire from. And once you get it in there, swing the little latch down, and now it's all good. So we can throw this, tuck that back in there, and this is what's going to go into the radio now. This cable right here, the green, yellow, and black, that is actually going to connect to this right here. This part goes to the screen, so we're going to route that straight up. And then the audio jack right here, of course, going to go right to this aux cable. Now I'm gonna try to route it down to so we can get the media controller down it here. So I'm gonna go ahead and pop this trim out. Just want to put it in drive and then pry all these tabs up. So I got this whole thing torn up now and gonna pop this little compartment thing out. And then this thing just slides straight in there. All right, so once you get this thing seated in there nicely, you just got this one wire that you need to route to the, but make sure when you route this cable that it comes up to this middle piece because it's gotta go with the rest of the harness. That actually looks pretty sick. And then you just want to take the cable that we routed up from this little thing. All right, and then once you grab the cable that you routed up from this button, that one just literally goes into this one from the harness. So this is how we got it looking now. This end goes into the back of the radio. And on the back of the screen is where we have the USB or Apple CarPlay that just plugs straight into that slot. Go ahead and get the screen mounted into up top. And then there's a little bracket that supports it from, you know, shaking all over the place. This bracket I'm talking about right here, and that's the hardware it comes with. So it lines up with these holes and those holes. So it's sitting there just like that, and then you bolt it in. So I got this, which powers the screen. I got it routed all the way through up here. And then this is the part that's gonna go into the back of the radio. So we're obviously just for the climate control little jump right here. I'm gonna go ahead and just throw all this shit back in. I think we're just gonna do the backup camera in like a week or two because Mason's going on vacation, leaving me lonely at work.
He left me like a month ago. Don't fucking do that.
All right, so we're plugging all back in before we mount it up top. Gonna make sure she actually works.
And she is. Wow. She's flying.
Hey! That's a good looking screen.
It took a little second.
It did take a little second.
We were a little nervous. That thing right there. Whoa,
I got this aux ran through the back here and then down just like the wire for this jump. And then it comes down here and you can take it underneath here and then go up through the hole if I'm athletic enough. And then you just want to plug it into the aux cord port right there.
Damn it!
All right, so for the USB, we just got this routed through here right now. And then as we showed you, we got the aux right down there, ran through there. So now we're just gonna figure out how to get this screen in there. We're having a little bit of fitment issues on this left side. As you can see, the little bracket that we just put on there earlier, two holes right here that these line up perfectly with. And the kit comes with two stainless bolts that you're just gonna bolt it down to the, and do those two holes that go right there. Once you get this bracket bolted in there, all you have left to do is run this up here to the screen and then the this one. So this is the two cords left. All right, so we mounted the screen, which it comes with these little U things, and it comes with these two bolts that you just mount the screen to the little plastic thingy. So after that, you want to pull up the two wires coming from the harness, and then you just want to plug them in and then get this screen mounted in there with the two bolts to the back. You know, she's sitting in there nice and pretty. This side's flush. This side's got like a little hair of a gap, but we're going to come back and mess with it a little bit later.
We all got a million things to go.
But other than that, it looks sick though. So we're going to slap this piece back in. All right, fellas. Well, we got it finished up. Everything bolted back in there. And that thing looks freaking mint.
It does.
What do you think? What are you thinking?
It is mint.
All right, you heard it here first. If you're interested in one, shop Webby's. Where they at?
ShopWebby.com.
If you buy one off of this video, I'll put a little discount code right in the corner. As y'all can see, we got this one for the ones without the iDrive screen. It's the same exact harness. All you gotta do is a little bit of cutting. Nice little upgrade from having nothing, no screen.
Big upgrade.
And now Mason can be entertained for his South Carolina drive.
Hey, right.
If you have iDrive. So I offer this Apple CarPlay on my website as well, Shop Webby's. The discount code that I popped up on the screen, y'all can use for any of the Apple CarPlays on the website. And then it has this little spin wheel so you can navigate through the menus and stuff. And you might have a little bit of issues with the audio at first, so you just wanna go to the equalizer and straighten everything out. All right, buddy, well, have a safe trip down to South Carolina.
All right, bro.
All right, yo. Yeah. Oh, and we got the new meat on the back. Forgot to say that. We got the new Michelin Pilot Sport, baby.
Okay.
All right, buddy.
All
right.
See you in about a week.
So, I'm actually about to pack up and then head down the road to Delaware. My parents have a beach house in Delaware. It's about a 3.5 hour drive from me. It's actually going to be the furthest I've ever driven the 335. So, I'm really curious to see how it's going to perform on a 3.5 hour drive. So, yeah, I'm going to get packed up and then head out. All right, so I'm all packed up. And a bunch of random stuff on my PC. Guys, I have a bunch of videos that are recorded but not edited, so I'm gonna try to catch up on some of that while I'm down there. Very importantly, we need to do something before we leave. Well, we got the white Crocs in sport mode on the right side, side that matters. We have a working cup holder. And we have a car that starts. Wish me the best of luck. I'm starving, so I'm definitely gonna sight some food. Y'all ever seen this before? Working cup holder? Come on, big dude. Turn it off. So far, I think I might have hit every single red light that there was possible. Dude, I'm telling you, every single one. My boost gauge is off 13 Percocets right now. They're throwing me some fresh E85, boys. This monster's got me off the shit.
I told my boy gon' roll like 10 blunts for me.
Well, the 335i made it. 3 hour trip. Proud of her. And all y'all calling 54s are unreliable. Come on now, bro. I'll drive all the way across the country. Watch. And I'll tell you one other thing. I never really got like uncomfortable. Like my back never hurt, so. Shout out BMW seats, too.
I'm trying to get high till I can't feel nothing.